I'm going to briefly describe how to use this interactive simulation for multi-stage batch distillation. The idea is we place 1 kmol of a binary mixture in the still. We let the system get to steady state before the simulation is even started. And steady state is obtained by having complete reflux, total reflux. And then when we hit collect, we collect in this flask, as it says here, an amount to evaporate 1/10 of a mole. So I'm showing the simulation after we've already evaporated 1/10 of a mole. This is the second flask. And we started out with the initial mole fraction of 0.25 of component B. That's something that we can change with the slider. As some is evaporated, notice now the mole fraction is 0.17. And the mole fraction when we start to collect the second flask is going to be 0.92 initially. And that happens when we hit this collect button here. Now we can change the amount that evaporates. Instead of evaporating 1/10 of a mole each time, we could make it 2/10 of a mole, for example, 0.25. We can change the number of equilibrium stages, and more equilibrium stages gives us better separation. We can change the reflux ratio. Higher reflux ratio gives us better separation. And then we can select what we display on the right side. Right now, I've selected the XY plot, but I could select the temperature XY plot, or I could select a view of the flasks that we are collecting. So far, we've collected one. It would show what's the composition in that flask. And then there's a reset button when we want to restart, change mole fractions, change stages, etc. So the simulation is set such that when the moles in the still gets to 0.2, the simulation stops. We can't evaporate anymore. So what we're going to do now is actually look at the actual simulation and observe how, as we change things, the system changes. So here's the simulation. And let's increase the number of equilibrium stages. And then when we evaporate 1/10 of a mole, we do that by hitting collect. And we see we're collecting the first batch, first flask, and the mole fraction is 0.92. So we've enriched from 0.25 to 0.92. Mole fraction of B, and then of course the mole fraction of B and the still has gone down because we preferentially depleted B, the more volatile component. If I hit collect again, we'll collect the next 0.1 moles, and now the mole fraction is decreased in the second flask because we've depleted it in the still, and we can continue doing that until we get down to 2/10 of a kmol in the flask. But notice now we're dramatically decreasing the amount of B in the still. We've actually done a pretty good separation. The remaining liquid in the still is 96% of component A. Now we could look, instead of the collected flask, we could look at the XY plot. And let's reset this to make it a little easier to see. And so when we start out, mole fraction of B in the still is 0.5. That's the blue dot in the diagram, the XY diagram. And the mole fraction we're collecting is 0.99. So you can see with a batch distillation, we have the potential to get very high concentrations, very high separations. And that's the point here, the red point. And then as we collect, these compositions shift on the XY plot. So now the mole fraction still is decreasing, and also the mole fraction in the distillate is decreasing. Continue to do that. Goes down some more. Now instead of the XY plot, we can look at the TXY plot. And let's continue to collect. So of course both mole fractions are decreasing. And notice the temperature in the still is increasing. The blue dot, I'll do one more collection. You can see the temperature in the still continues to go up. If we look at the, hold the mouse over the stages, we can see the compositions and the temperature in each stage. Here we can see the composition being collected. Let's reset this. We can get better separations by increasing the number of equilibrium stages and increasing the reflux ratio. And so I'm going to display the flask if we, and let's collect more. We collect, notice now the mole fraction is 0.997 of the initial material coming over. So with more stages and high reflux, we can get very high purity component B. So the first 0.19 moles, kilomoles that we collect is 99.6% of component B. And we've depleted significant amount of B in the still. So batch distillation has the potential to give us very high separations if we have stages and reflux.